Secretary to the Treasury Ramadan Gobi made the remarks while appearing before Parliament's Public Accounts Committee, where the Ministry of Finance, Planning and Economic Development had been summoned to respond to the queries raised in the December 2023 Auditor General's report. MPs quizzed officials from the Ministry of Finance over the unrealistic budget that ended up affecting the government's ability to provide services to Ugandans.
In the year under review, we had a budget of 52.548 trillion. In the year previous to this one, we had the budget of 51.561 trillion. In the other year before this one, we had a budget of 42.74 trillion.
Please allow the people who have the research, who have the ability to analyze numbers and give them to you as policymakers to inform the budget.
Mwanga Chivumbi, the MP of Butambala County and chairperson of the Public Accounts Committee, pointed out what the ministry budgets for the nation and what the government is able to spend.
The one we have right now that was brought to Parliament by you, it's about 50 by the planners. It's still about 52 trillion. It's not near 45 where you are performing.
In the financial year under review, the initial revenue and expenditure budget estimates for the government were 48.132 trillion, which was later revised to 48.136 trillion shillings. Although the revised revenue budget remained at 48.136 trillion, the expenditure budget was revised to a total of 52.548 trillion shillings in the course of the year, leading to unbalanced budget of 4.41 trillion shillings.
The country is treated to a challenge.
I have not yet agreed.
To some occasion of function in Parliament that is never realistic. But also, you base on this untrue figure to do a 3% at the beginning of every financial year.
And the figures don't lie, or they can be explained from their language. Let's now focus, give him time, and then maybe from that point you tell us about the figures.
When you look at the way we have been financing it, the money we have to spend on the various budgeted items, if it runs out, we stop there. We don't spend money we don't have. So if the accusation here is that we are spending less than what we had anticipated, it's actually what has kept Uganda afloat.
However, a section of MPs got defensive at Gobi's remarks of blaming policymakers for the distortions in the budget, although the Secretary to the Treasurer defended his stance.
The policymakers should consider the input from the research team. Where do these people come from? Because I think these are technical people that cook the budget for us to analyze.
Who issues the warrants?
On the issue of the warrant, we are going there. It is 1.2, it's the next
but
one.
Who issues them? Just simple. Is it a policymaker?
The Secretary to the Treasury's rebuttal was, however, rejected by Mwanga, who emphasized that unrealistic budgeting is a deliberate move to portray unrealistic economic growth.
These assumptions have been thrown out of the window by a number of shocks. They are shocks which have affected us, media. You planned a budget, Ebola. You planned a budget, there is this war. Then changes all the fundamentals.
Looking at a trend, and a persistent and consistent trend. If you established a consistent line of trend, that's a weakness. That's a weakness. If you are saying of this year, exempt year, that was this crisis, understandable.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.